Yeah, here I'm having a problem based on time, speed and distance. So particularly this is the case of boats and streams, right? A boat goes 30 kilometer upstream and 44 kilometer downstream in 10 hours. In 13 hours it can go 40 kilometer upstream and 55 kilometer downstream. What is the speed of the stream? A simple problem, friends. What is the upstream speed? See, when the boat is going against the stream, right, against the flow of the stream, then the effective speed is reduced, right? Suppose the speed of the boat is x kilometer and the speed of the stream is y, then effective speed, upstream speed, will be x minus y kilometer per hour. And downstream means the boat is going in the flow, with the flow of stream, so the effective speed is increased, right? If the speed of boat is x and speed of stream is y, so effective speed will be x plus y kilometer per hour. Now we are getting two equations in this case. 30 kilometer upstream, it will take this much time, plus 44 kilometer downstream, it will take this much time, and total time is 10 hours, right? And similarly, 40 kilometer upstream and 55 kilometer downstream, and the total time is 13 hours. Now you need to solve these two equations. These are simultaneous equation. You can assume the values of x minus y, x plus y, and then you can solve. And alternatively, if you don't want to solve the equation, you need to do some mental exercise, some guesswork. See, you can see a solution of this equation is an integral value. Solution of this equation is also an integral value, right? And you can say, see, 44 and 55. X plus y is factor of 44 and 55, both of them. So instantly you can say x plus y must be 11, right? Similarly, x minus y is factor of 30 and 40, both. It may be 5, may be 10, right? X minus y may be 5, may be 10. But if I put x plus y as 11 over here, I'll be getting 4, right? So 30 upon x minus y will be 6. In that case, x minus y has to be 5, right? Okay, you put here, it's a 40 by 5, that's 8, and 55 by 11, that's 5. 8 plus 5, 13. So pretty clear that x plus y is 11 and x minus y is 5. Now you need the value of y, speed of the stream, right? If you need the smaller value, deduct this from this and divide it by 2, right? That means this equation minus this equation, that is 11 minus 5, that's 6. 6 by 2, 3, right? So 2y is 6, y is equal to 3 kilometer per hour, right? So if you do this way, then you'll be able to save a great extent of time. I hope you are clear. I'll take one more to elaborate this. Here it is 24 kilometer upstream, so 24 upon x minus y plus 28 downstream, and the total time is 6 hours. And 30 kilometer upstream and 21 kilometer downstream, and the total time is 6.5 hours, or you can say 13 by 2 hours. That 2 I take over here. Okay, further I am getting two equations. Need to do guesswork. Say x plus y, 28 and 42. It should be factor of 28 and 42, so we can assume it to be 7, maybe 14 also, but let's take 7. So 28 by 7, this quantity is 4, right? So that means this quantity must be 2. So this quantity is 2, for that x minus y should be 12. So if x plus y is 7, x minus y cannot be 12. So I take x plus y as 14, right? So 28 by 14, this is 2. That means this quantity must be 4. That means x minus y must be 6, right? So x plus y is 14, x minus y is 6. Verify this. Here, this is 42 by 14, this is 3, and 60 by 6, that is 10. 10 plus 3, 13. Pretty clear. In this case, we need the speed of the boat, that means the value of x, that is 14 plus 6, 20 by 2, 10 kilometer per hour. Okay, so simple guessing we are doing, but our guessing is 100% accurate. No need to worry, because we are not just guessing over here, we are verifying it from the other equation. Okay, I hope you are clear with the method.